This is what the developers should be doing right now. Hiding their faces. Yeah. Let's get into it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the YouTube citizens, y'all know who this is. It's your boy Truant. Ow. As I hit my camera.
How do you do that?
It's your boy Truant, and today's day is Friday, October the 28th. And yes, I will be doing this entire video dressed like this with this hood over my face. Because random. Or it's Halloween and I'm in disguise. There you go.
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
What this video is about. So obviously, you know, I have to get my two cents on the whole Zoroa debacle that happened this past Tuesday. So here's what was supposed to happen based on what went down in New Zealand. So this past Tuesday, it was Spotlight Hour, you know, Shuppet Spotlight Hour. But the catch was that the first 5 minutes of the last 5 minutes of Spotlight Hour, wherever your buddy Pokemon was, that Pokemon would be spawning all over the place. So it don't matter if it was a legendary, if it was a shiny, like heck, even shinies were spawning. Like you can even see the shinies form on the map. And we click on one, it was a shiny, or whatever the case may be. Now, once you click on that Pokemon and you catch it, it's gonna change to Zoroark. And that was a cool way to introduce it into the game. And it was supposed to happen for the first 5 minutes of Spotlight Hour and the last 5 minutes of Spotlight Hour, like I said. Well, it only happened within the first 5 minutes of Spotlight Hour, not the last 5 minutes, which was interesting. But more importantly than that, there was a problem because Zoroark took the CP, it took the stats, it took the shape and size, whatever the case may be, of your buddy Pokemon. So if your buddy Pokemon, for example, was a Mega 100% IV Gyarados that you powered up to the max, which is like at, what is it, 5,500 CP something, you're gonna capture a Zoroark with that stats, with that CP, with that height and rate. And that's a problem. Now, granted, once you evolve it, that CP goes down to match wherever it was supposed to be, you know, in this evolved form, whatever. But the fact that people had Zoroark at 5,000 CP, 4,000 CP, whatever the case may be, that's the problem. And they had the stats and the moves of that buddy Pokemon. That was a problem to the point where they completely shut it down for everybody else. And a lot of people got upset because they really want Zoroark. And they really like this feature. So there you go with that. Now here's my thoughts about this. And somebody tweeted this out. And you know, actually not somebody, a number of people tweeted this out actually, and that's this. And people are wondering, do Niantic test these features out? Because this is basically strike two right here. This is the second straight time, as my phone's running off, this is the second straight time where Niantic added a new feature into the game. And it didn't work out well. So the other time was the Elite Raid system. Now, in terms of raiding the Hoopa, okay, that part was fine and dandy, but it's what happened after that. And I talked about this in a previous video, but let me bring it up again. Where Pokemon that was not within that radius of the gym where you defeated the Hoopa, they was like those rare Pokemon replicates maybe were spawned outside of that radius. Like, for example, I gave you an example of how there was a Galarian Mr. Mime that was showing up at a Pokestop that was not near the gym. So when you try to go down there to catch it, it won't be there. It's gonna despawn. It won't show up in that Pokestop anymore because you're now outside of that radius. So that was a failed feature in my opinion. And that's the one that really they should have worked on, because then there's a video of Mystic Seven trying to click on a Zapdos. Poop, disappear. I believe Fleece King went for it as well. And I think Brandaton did as well. So yeah, that's a problem. And now we got this. So now people are wondering, yo, do they even test these features out? Or do they look at New Zealand and be like, yo, we need you guys to test this feature out before we keep it in the game or not? So, but yeah, that's a problem. And I don't think it's right for New Zealand to be test subjects. Let's call it like it is. Like they being used as test subjects. And that shouldn't be the case. Like this stuff should have been tested before it is released to New Zealand, AKA, and then pretty much the rest of the world. So that's a problem right there. Now, for those of you who really want Zoroark into the game, so all I'ma say is this. While I don't know when we're gonna get Zoroark into the game, but I'ma make a prediction. This is just a prediction. I know nothing, this is just a prediction. I truly believe that we don't have to wait long to get Zoroark. I don't know when, again, I don't know when it's going to be in the game, but all I'm going to say is we don't have to wait long for it to appear in the game. And that's all I'm going to say about that. So, again, wherever new features that is added to the game, please test it. Please test it before you release it out in New Zealand and then ultimately the rest of the world to avoid this. Because, again, here's the thing. Like, ever since the whole shop fiasco where the items, prices of the items have been going up pretty much, they kind of been walking on eggshells. So now you have two new features that were cool in theory, cool in concept, but the execution wasn't there and they failed pretty much miserably. It's not a good look right now. It's really not a good look. So test these features out. Like, I like the idea of bringing new features to the game to make the game exciting, but you gotta test these features out. So when they work well, you get the praise and things will be up for the game and for the company. But yeah, they gotta test these features out, man. I'm not saying that they didn't, I don't know. It just didn't seem like it because again, two straight new features failed miserably. So that's all I gotta say about that. And guess what? I'm calling it a wrap. So with all that said, y'all know what this is. This is brand new J Gatsby, AKA new Stephen A. Smith, saying peace out, y'all, and I'll see y'all next time. Now where's the camera? I can't see the camera. There it is. Bam. And yes, I will be doing this entire video dressed like this with this hood over my face.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Thanks, man. After you subscribe to the channel, make sure you click the bell icon so you never miss a new video or a live stream ever again. Thanks, guys. Lewis the trainer, articulating paint. With my tongue, I done things that people said I can't. Now they rank them with the elite, but it's for the people, and victory is part of defeat. Cause when you get back on your feet, then you try again. Learn from mistakes, show them that I got what it takes, and I'm dying to win. Okay. I'ma hit and move away.